Hey guys, here we are back on Wind Chaser. I figured I'd do a little funny video today. I was really kind of in the mood to play with some rusty, junky old equipment, and so I went on Mod Hoster, and I've never actually ever really used any of these old combines, so I figured I would go ahead and use it. It has nice functions like door and ladder, you know, just simple animations, and you can move the hitch and stuff like that. And so I figured I was just going to harvest a little bit of corn with this. We rented a Lexion 770 to help out with our corn harvest, just to give that a little bit of, you know, after a couple hours of working on it, it's in pretty decent shape now. But we own a New Holland 990, and it works really good. Probably going to stick with New Holland for a while, but figured I was going to just spend a couple $100 and rent this thing for the corn harvest. And on our server, we only have 10 and 6 and 7 to go, but 6 and 7 aren't even ready to harvest yet. So we harvested all of our fields, got all of our crop in, and we're just finishing up our corn harvest. Probably have, I don't know, 300, you know, 200,000-300,000 more liters to go. So we're just coming back from the dealer. Right along the old, main dairy farm here. Nice power lines, and you can see the trees and wind turbines. And we're just putzing along, nice roads here. So we did pretty well in our canola, and we did pretty well in our soybeans. I was hoping for around 500,000. We ended up around 560,000 liters of beans, so that will help out. I guess we pulled in about a little, like, right around 98,000 in hay between the north part of 11 and a little bit of field 20. I don't know, I wasn't around when they mowed it and merged it and sold it, so that's what they tell me. It was right around like 70 some odd bales out of 20. So here's our field 10. I think Mike was working on this with the Lexion. There's the train cruising by. So we'll go out, turn on our lights here. Need to unfold our tank. Pretty cool. Start it up. To the races. Oh, that's right, this is a little staggered. So the boys don't know I went ahead and I picked this up, but I think it's great. It's cheap. He's really kicking that corn out there. Got our door open. Just sounds like a bunch of metal pieces are hitting one another. It's awesome. Curious how far we can go. I wonder if they will even reach the over the Kinsey. I have my doubts. Silly little harvester. It works pretty good, actually. Probably turn on our beacons when we're going down the road. I really like how it looks, though. Nice, rusty, old piece of equipment. I think it's, Russian, but who cares? Looks like an old Massey Ferguson or something. I like the warmth of the lights. It has that incandescent feel to it, not the bright halogen or thing is just cruising. like how the gears and everything spin. Just the little details. I mean, not very difficult to do, but... Oh, they do have the chain. No, they don't. You know, rotation nodes, so... I'm a huge fan of little details like that. You know, it doesn't take any time to script them in or stuff, but it sure looks good when you're in game and seeing all the pulleys and mechanisms. We have a really good corn crap one. Wow, they even put the collisions on the pipe. Giants can't even do that. I wonder what that does. I wonder if that works like kind of like a shaker, like a sieve kind of thing, like you're panning for gold. Not quite sure, but that would be my hunch. Actually, we just need to pipe out. Here's the rusty non-looped gears. You don't even hear the engine really. I'm gonna make Jake run this. He's always telling me to get bigger and bigger stuff, so I think I'm gonna stick him in this for a little bit. think it was borderline a snowplow. That discharge node's a little bit off the particles, but we're clearing a decent amount of ground with this. This thing's a workhorse.